A fairly standard Thursday arvo on the New South Central Downs, pulling fences round the local cattle farms. Finish early, pack the ute and to the Tattersalls in town for a couple of games of pool and spin some yarns. All the usual crowd were in, some local shearers at the bar, a few old cockies with their wives and kids as well, and a wiry little stranger who had blown in from afar. A pig hunter from up north, what we could tell. Pulling up a stump, he told us of his pig hunting prowess, how no pig had yet escaped his fierce dog's grip. Though it was apparent that his stories were a bit far-fetched at best, and this hog Dundee was clearly full of shit. For the Cape was his backyard. All the NT boys were gay, and our New South Wales pigs were just for girls. His last boar had dressed 200. His dog could find 10 Ks and he'd box 20 every night and make a pearl. And he urged us to go with him to inspect his homemade plate. The best design you'll see, so we were told. So with a grin, we drank our schooners and followed out old mate to the street where stood his beat-up red patrol. The dog he had was pretty standard. Bully ridgeback, something cross, an athletic build with many scars he bore. And with a grin, Dundee unchained him and pulled out a large toolbox to reveal the homemade chest plate that he wore. Now this plate was more an armour, in the true Ned Kelly style, a full-length metal jacket, crudely shaped, complete with studs and shoulder pads, a sticker, Dog and Wild, and finished with a sheet of checker plate. This dog suit of welds and rivets was a sight for us to behold as it hung down from two hinges along the back. The shaping of the shoulder pads was oversized and bold as it locked home with a deadbolt on the neck. It was worn and scratched and dented as he'd crafted it to fit the shoulders of his battle-hardened hound. But his movement was quite free. He could run and jump and sit and somewhat scratch himself and roll around. We could not deny the thought and skill that had gone into the job, the workmanship, the welds that had been done. But still, we doubted it would offer full protection for a dog, if tested by a good boar on the run. By now, some passers-by had gathered round as Dundee's voice grew loud, and they heard grand tales of boars he'd battled, near and far. But we'd heard enough and left him with his captivated crowd, and retreated to the safety of the bar. Now, all this talk of pigs and plates had got us pretty keen, and so on dusk we collared up the dogs to a local loosen block where we'd been told a boar had been to see if we could nail ourselves a hog. The night was getting on a bit. We'd caught a pig or two. We thought we'd pack it in as the air was getting cold, when we spied a set of foreign lights in the field we'd just been through. It was the outline of a beat-up red patrol. It turned out Dundee had followed us as we headed out of town to use our local country for a run. So we threw up the dogs and headed back to try and chase him down. But he tore off and a high-speed chase begun. In wild circles round the loosen blocks and out towards the road, we ran as Dundee dimmed down all his lights. And standing stark against the ute tray, our spotty clearly showed his dog's reflective chest plate in the night. So Dundee reached the tarmac road and hooked it towards town, and we followed on some 20 yards behind. The chase was too much fun, and we were headed home anyhow. A pig-rigged drag race towards the city limit signs. Now, up at the next bridge, a big black boar had chanced to stand, and as we approached, it did but stand and wait. And it was then that we could understand the genius of the man in constructing a dog suit of checker plate. For his dog had seen the pig and had launched from off the tray before Dundee had even slowed his speed. He landed chest first on the tarmac in a shower of sparks and spray, slid straight to his feet and hit top speed. Now Dundee had seen the pig as well and swung wildly off the road in the direction that he knew his dog had jumped to cut off the boar's escape route through the thick green undergrowth of kabungi, bracken fern and willow stumps. Then came an almighty smash as we pulled off to the side and swung our spotlight to his motionless patrol. It stood completely still and silent, with its front end out of sight. Dundee had nosedived in a massive washout hole. Undeterred, his dog ran swiftly to pursue the fleeing boar into the shadows of the grass and fallen logs. The patrol creaked and groaned as Dundee fell quite limply out the door and began to crawl in the direction of his dog. In our spotlight, I could glimpse his dog stride out across the plain and chase the pig to where the scrub grew dense, and through into the neighbours who had a new fruit tree plantain surrounded by a three-wire electric fence. Now the pig had done this run before from several escapes prior and burrowed through the fence without a zap, but the dog became entangled and got caught up in the wires, which lodged firmly in his massive shoulder pads. Now, a full-length metal jacket is a nasty thing to wear if you decide to get caught in an electric fence. The dog suit was now one big electrode which was fastened firmly there, and to escape, the poor dog never stood a chance. So as the mournful howls rung out across the moonlit valleyway, like some eerie chorus of the Baskerville hounds, whether the dog had caught the pig or not, we really couldn't say, unaware of the hot wires that had him bound. So with Dundee convinced his faithful mate had come off second best, and with his chances to outrun us now looking bleak, caught red-handed, half concussed, and with his vehicle laid to rest, he found himself without a paddle whilst up a well-known creek. Eventually the cops turned up to take Dundee into town, and with exhausted grins we sent him on his way. We retrieved his dog, who, though exhausted, was content to just lay down by his master in the paddy wagon cage. And that next Saturday we met up with a bloke called Teddy Rocher with his tow truck to collect the Red Patrol. And we still laugh about the arvo we spent with the Checkerplate Poacher and the washout we now know as Dundee's Hole.